At the end of the Cours de l'Homme stands the old sawmill that used to cut the timber for the woodworkers that worked and lived in the courtyard. This French polisher explained to me the varnish he used in his craft. Gumlax, he said, was the sap of the jujubier tree, which grew in India. It came in various qualities and colors.
Il y a différentes qualités, hein. Il y en a de la orange, de la rouge, de la transparente. Voilà. Et maintenant je réessuie. On le fait en deux fois toujours.
To find a pleasant concierge is like finding a pearl beyond price. Hélène, who's been here in this courtyard for 27 years, told me that when she'd come, there had been 30 different trades in the court.
Mais il y avait beaucoup d'artisans. Oh, il y avait une trentaine d'artisans.
My job was to clean the stairs every day. I would sweep and wash my stairs every day. In those days, we used to brush the stairs by hand. And I would take the post up three times a day.
Les paliers à la broche, évidemment. Et je montais le courrier tous les jours.
What was amusing was on summer nights when the windows were open and you heard everything. Often on the following morning, I would say, last night you were quarreling, but today you are arm in arm, like two lovers. Yes, I used to say that. Everyone was very friendly. Okay, you do it for me. You're very nice, I said, not like most concierges.
Ils sont pas gentils.
They're not nice then, concierge.
Ben, vous savez, oh, il y a des fois, je vais vous dire un truc, je gueule.
I do shout sometimes. What are you doing there?
Hey, qu'est-ce que tu fais là?
You do that all the time.
Voilà, voilà, voilà ce qu'on dit.
There you are, listen to what he says.
Voilà.
On the other side of the courtyard is Madame Flay, one of the most respected leather workers in Paris, specializing in embossing leather of all sorts. Apart from teaching her the embosser's trade, her father left her the biggest collection of embossing tools in Paris. King of the courtyard goes for his morning stroll. Another day in the Cours de l'Homme comes to an end. Let's hope the developers don't move in too soon and rip out the heart of Paris.